My favorite memory would be going back home for Christmas, specifically to my grandmother's house. My mom's the youngest of seven, so it's always a big family affair. I get to see all of my cousins, aunts, and uncles, and when we were all younger, it was great to get together because you have all these kids you can run around the house with, and always seeing my mother decorate her house to the nines for Christmas, and it actually snows in Virginia, unlike being in the South, so it was always fun to actually go somewhere where it feels like Christmas. That's definitely one of my most treasured memories.
I'm the seventh of 10 kids. Christmas morning was always just chaotic and so much fun. That excitement of coming and waking up, getting out of bed and coming into the living room and seeing all the presents under the tree. Whenever my wife and I had our three kids, we wanted to share that with them. So as a father, even as much fun as it was to be a child on Christmas morning, it for me could not be surpassed by the joy of my own kids and experiencing that. A thing that we love to do also, we love to drive around and look at the Christmas lights, and we started that real young, and by the time we were through, whenever my kids were little, they would be asleep by the time we had looked at all the lights and just the memory of that, and we do that now they're out of the house, and whenever they come back, we ride around and look at the Christmas lights.
Well, one of our favorite family traditions in my family is to get together and watch the original Home Alone. And this is not a streaming or on Netflix or Hulu. This is the 1990 VHS tape in a VCR that we play every year and watch it as a family. And it's so fun to get together with my nephew and my niece, my brother and sister-in-law, my mom, my sister, and we all pile on the couch with blankets and popcorn and watch the original movie. And we all have our favorite quotes, and we all have our favorite scenes in the movie. And it's fun to introduce this to my niece and nephew who have never seen the movie, and maybe the technology from the 1990s is all new to them as well. So it's so much fun. And one year, my nephew got inspired by Kevin in the movie and wanted to booby trap the whole house. So we had strings tied to doorknobs and stepping over things through the whole holidays. And it was just a lot of fun and a lot of memories there. And so we do this every year and it's so much fun and we look forward to it every year.
Hey, I'm meteorologist Ben Lang wishing you a Merry Christmas. If all goes according to plan for me, then by the time you're seeing this, I should be back home in Memphis with my immediate family, getting to wind down, enjoy some holiday time. And by chance, if you're not able to spend the holiday with your friends or your family, then I totally understand. Working in television, I end up working on most holidays, but just a reminder that you can make a holiday your own any day of the year. Prepare a nice meal, get some food catered, invite over your family and friends. It doesn't matter. You can make it Christmas Day any day of the year if you want. So, again, just wanting to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
I just want to simply say Happy Holidays and Merry Christmas to all those out there. And remember, it's very important to treasure your family, especially in these hard times. So, Happy Holidays.
I'd like to wish everyone and their family a very Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
I'm Rab McGuire. From my family to yours, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year.
From all of us at Alabama News Network, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
He was born 2,000 years ago in a manger in Bethlehem. All history is dated by that birth. He never owned a pillow on which to rest his head or a house in which to sleep. He had no publicity men, no gimmicks, no worldwide organization, sought no fame or glory, refused all political honors, and yet he changed the world as no other person in the long history of mankind. He had no congregation, yet he typified the best ministry in all the history of religion. In 3 years, he accomplished more than all the armies that ever marched on the face of the earth. For he revolutionized the human spirit as he healed the sick, gave hope to the downtrodden, and administered to the poor. His spirit was not like that of any man, for his was the Spirit of God. This Christmas, we commend to you the life and works of the incomparable Jesus Christ, without whom there is no real Christmas.
Well, one of our favorite family memories in my, let me just get this, hold on. I'd like to wish everyone and their families a very healthy and happy Merry Christmas and let me do that over. I'd like to wish everyone and their families a very safe Christmas this year and a healthy, happy new, I don't know what I'm saying. Okay, I'm gonna keep it short. I'd like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas. God. I can't even say it. No, no. No. Oh my God. 3, 2. Now I've like totally lost my train of thought. Please don't make me do it over here.